Well, Grantley's done it. He's evoked Odin and we've got some wind. And guess what? We're loving it. Remember before when I told you it was raining? I was wrong. It's raining now. And if you don't believe me, just watch it running off the sail. Here we are, Pillinger.
The old wharves at Pillinger are a reminder that this was once a bustling port and the end of the railway line from Crotty that took copper from the North Mount Lyell mine.
Oh, mate, it's been a bit of an effort to get here. We passed the 100k mark today. I think we're up to 115 for the trip. We're at Reindeer Lodge, a converted railway carriage from bygone years. Hey, check it out. Come inside.
Bump your head.
Our resident stake.
Who have we got here? Grantley. And Rexy, babe.
Rex, Albatross Brown here.
Sea kayaking essential tucker.
Yeah.
Relish, cheese, and salami.
Yep.
It's hard to believe that this thick bush now hides the remains of the extensive township of West Pillinger. Pillinger grew rapidly with four hotels, athletic club, wood chopping arenas, school, cemetery and a sawmill. In 1900, the railway to Linda opened and there were 637 residents in the town. In August 1898, 122 Crown land allotments were auctioned. The bidding was brisk and 108 were sold. Clearing the bush and erection of buildings started quickly, but in December of that year the post office burnt down. In the same year, a number of houses on illegally occupied Crown land were pulled down by police, and some families were turned out into the inclement weather. The population peaked in 1902 at around 1,000 people. But the following year saw the merger of the Mount Lyell Mining and North Mount Lyell companies. With a railway and port at Strawn, Pillinger became redundant, and by 1906 only 50 people remained at the town. Wandering through the rainforest in recent years, reveal some traces of gardens that were started over 120 years ago. We found the frame of a railway wagon built at Gawler in South Australia. A large blackwood tree was slowly destroying this relic of the past. In 2002, we decided to walk the railway line from West Pillinger to East Pillinger. I think we're on the bridge right now.
Yeah. Oh, the red gum or cherry, not cherry, Jerry. This is.
You go first. This involved crossing the Clark River, hopefully by trestle railway bridge. How deep's deep? That's bloody deeper than mine, eh?
Feel comfortable with us? So you should. All the effort to get here, and now wait till you see the brickworks.
Over at East Pillinger, are extensive ruins with signage by Parks. Financed by London investors, the outlet for the North Mount Lyell copper mine was here. The three brick kilns could fire 348,000 bricks at a time, enough to build 13 three-bedroom houses. The bricks from Pillinger were sent by rail to the North Mount Lyell workings at Crotty to build the smelters that extracted the copper. Unfortunately today, the remains of the Crotty smelters are under the hydro lake Burberry and only visible in very dry years. By 1899, the problems of gambling and drinking at Kelly Basin were described as riotous living. Drinking on Sundays and vile language by men under the influence of alcohol resulted in a police raid on several sly grog shops. This was despite the presence of four licensed hotels in the town. Old brickworks, boilers and rusting relics are an impressive reminder of more prosperous days. Despite a rich copper ore deposit, poor smelting techniques, wasteful management, and the death of James Crotty, the instigator of the scheme, saw the company fold. The last hotel closed in 1925, and the last resident left in 1943. Pillinger was certainly a boom and bust town.
What do you reckon about the wind tomorrow? What's it going to do? Going to be in our face?
Murphy's Law says yes.
Sailing all tomorrow.
Oh, good. Okay. Trip leader has spoken. He's in deep doo doo if he's wrong.
Check to see we've got everything. Oh well, off we go. Let's hope we get back again for another adventure.
Reindeer Lodge. Adios.
We're not happy when there's too much wind. Now we're not happy when it's flat. These old farts, I don't know.